adding a patient. Occasionally, a patient's chart may not be found within the registry. When this happens, a patient's chart must then be added. In this example, we will search for last name Test, first name George, and a date of birth of 8/8/2000, and select Search. When a patient's chart is not located within a registry, a confirm message will appear indicating that no matches were found. Would you like to use the fuzzy date of birth? Click Yes to broaden the search results. If there are still no matches, a message indicator will appear stating that no matches were found for search criteria. Click OK, Reset, and broaden the search to contain the full last name, first initial, and date of birth. Select Search. If the patient's chart is not located within the registry, a confirm message will appear indicating that no matches were found. Would you like to use a fuzzy date of birth? Click Yes to broaden the search results. If there are still no matches, a message indicator will appear stating no matches were found for the search criteria. Click OK and Add. Next, the Add New Client screen will appear. All yellow fields are required. It is important to first complete the patient's full first name. In the Record Number field, you now have the option to enter your patient's unique number assigned by your practice when you are adding the patient into the registry. A chart number can contain any combination of letters or numbers up to 10 characters. Even though adding a chart number is optional, you will find this feature extremely useful because searching by chart number will yield an exact match. Notice the record field automatically defaults to PCP for primary care provider. Using the drop-down menus, select their sex, race, and ethnicity. Be sure to always review that the patient's information is correct before selecting OK. George is now added to the registry.